Hello everyone, and welcome to our new reality. At the beginning of our course, I would like to play for you the song from late 80s and early 90s, the time when I was teenager and in my early 20s, and that song was very popular and inspiring then. And then I find that the lyrics of the song are very inspiring today, particularly in our situation. So let me go to YouTube. As you can see, I am learning how to share my screen and how to use the Blackboard Collaborate Ultra. And here we have the song. So have fun.
Spaces, what are we living for? Abandoned places, I guess we know this score. On and on, does anybody know what we are looking for? Another hero, another mindless crime behind the curtain. In the pantomime, hold the line. Does anybody want to take it anymore? Show must go on. Show must go on. Yeah. Inside my heart is breaking. My makeup may be flaking, but my smile stays on. Whatever happens, I leave it all to chance.
So, as I said, the lyrics were inspiring then and they're inspiring today. Despite the coronavirus, the show of our life must go on. Welcome to the romantic era. And stay with me because I'm sharing my PowerPoint. Here we go. So on the left side, you see Frédéric Chopin. In the middle, you see Franz Schubert. And on the right, Peter Tchaikovsky. The dates of the Romantic period are from 1820 to 1900. These are generalized dates of the Romantic period. Our textbooks or encyclopedias may have slightly different dates, but almost all agree that with the beginning of the 20th century, or at the latest by the second decade of the 20th century, everything, including music, was rapidly and radically changing. The 19th century also witnessed many changes. Politically, the Monroe Doctrine, named after the American president, was introduced, which stated the opposition of the United States to any European colonialism in both Americas. From then on, any form of control of any independent South American countries would be viewed as, I quote, the manifestation of an unfriendly disposition toward the United States, end of quote. As a result of this doctrine, at the end of the 19th century, the Spanish-American War took place in 1898. Also, let's not forget that in the 19th century, the Industrial Revolution took place. The railroad and steamboats were speeding up communication. New textile manufacturing techniques were introduced. Also, major agricultural changes were implemented to multiply the crops. Urbanization took place, and cities like New York and Chicago were born. All the above changes made investors very wealthy and left the working class struggling. It was a time when the business of slavery was flourishing. And here we have the painting of by the French painter Daumier, which depicts people of the working class in a cramped train compartment. The title of the painting is The Third Class Carriage. In 1849, Marx and Engels proclaimed their Communist Manifesto as a result of the unfair treatment of the working class. In 1859, Charles Darwin published his revolutionary work on the origin of species. Darwin developed the theory of biological evolution, meaning that all species and organisms develop through natural selection and the individual ability to survive and reproduce. He believed that the human race evolved from a monkey or an ape. Queen Victoria started her reign in England, lasting almost 70 years. The end of the 19th century was marked with many wars and revolutions, including, mentioned before, the Spanish-American War in 1898. Romanticism was a cultural movement. Emotions, imagination, and individuality became most important. Romanticism was so diverse that it couldn't be defined by any single word. The movement was international and influenced all of the arts. The basic quality of romanticism in art was a spontaneous overflow of powerful feelings. For the first time, artists projected their personalities in their works. Romantics were gravitating to the world of fantasy and the world of dreams. For romantics, the Middle Ages presented a world of the unknown, the fantastic, and the distant. The romantics were inspired by medieval folk ballads and by tales of fantasy and adventure. As a contrast, neoclassicists considered the medieval period to be the Dark Ages. A Gothic revival took place. Both the Parliament in London and Trinity Church in New York were built in the Gothic style. Gothic style played a special role in art. On the other slide, you will see the Trinity Church in New York, with grounds of the cemetery where Hamilton is buried. Here you see the Trinity Church with its steeple. On the upper picture, you see the cemetery grounds by the church, and on the bottom, the interiors of the church. And the church is in the heart of Manhattan. Romantic painters used brilliant colors. They wanted to portray action, movement. Subjective feelings and emotions were the leading elements in romantic art and music. And here you can see the painting by the French artist Delacroix, titled In Liberty Leading the People. And here is lady leading French Revolution. In Romantic art and music, nature became very important. It was seen as a consolation for the tormented human heart and soul. Poets thought of nature as the nurse, the guide, the guardian, the soul. We can see nature in art, and we can hear it in music. As I mentioned before, it was time when the slavery was blooming. And here we have the painting by the English painter Turner titled Slave Ship. Slavers throwing overboard the dead and dying, typhoon coming on. And you can see in the distance a ship. During the 19th century, many concert halls like Carnegie Hall in New York were built, where Tchaikovsky came from Russia to conduct his works for its opening. Also, in the second half of the 19th century, the first music conservatories throughout Europe and the USA were founded. Before the 19th century, women were permitted to study music performance, but in the Romantic era, they were also able to study composition and theory. The Romantic era lasted only 8 years, but it was probably the most prolific in all art and music. There is a long list of Romantic composers about whom we'll be talking. The list is not complete, but they were the most important composers of the Romantic period. Among the most significant were Franz Schubert, Robert Schumann, Clara Wieck Schumann, Frédéric Chopin, Franz Liszt, Felix Mendelssohn, Hector Berlioz, Peter Tchaikovsky, Bedřich Smetana, Antonín Dvorak, Johannes Brahms, Georges Bizet, Giuseppe Verdi, Giacomo Puccini, Richard Wagner, and Gustav Mahler. I would recommend you to remember those names because you will be asked about them in your test or quiz. Romantic composers continued to use the musical forms of the classical era. The emotional intensity associated with Romanticism was already present in the works of Mozart and particularly works of Beethoven. As you remember, Beethoven was like a bridge between classical and Romantic composers. His imprint on the musical style of many Romantic era composers was enormous. The Romantic composers were influenced by some elements of the classical era, depicting song-like melodies and expression. But there are also many differences between Romantic and classical music. Romantic works tend to have a greater range of tone color, dynamics, and pitch. Harmonic vocabulary is broader, with more emphasis on unstable chords. Romantic music has greater tension, less balance, and resolution. Romantic music is very diverse. For example, some Romantic composers, such as Mendelssohn and Brahms, composed works that were deeply rooted in the classical tradition. And others like Berlioz and Wagner were completely revolutionary. It is difficult and unfair to try to make any conclusive generalization of the style. Individuality of the style was a key element of that period. Most Romantic composers were trying to compose in their own style so their music could be easily recognized and associated with their names. The Romantics acquired a universe of feelings that included flamboyance and intimacy, unpredictability and melancholy, rapture and longing. Countless songs glorified romantic love. They were fascinated by imagined possibilities and diabolical events that were expressed in music, such as the dream of a witch's Sabbath from Berlioz's Symphony Fantastique. And here I would like to play for you just a short excerpt of this movement. But for this purpose, I again have to share my screen with you. And we have to go back to YouTube. And we would like to go to the... Can you hear witches coming together and preparing party? And now we are moving back to sharing my files to my PowerPoint presentation. Stop sharing the screen here and share now here. So I'm back with you. And I have to find the slide. Yes, this is it. So, Romantic musicians were attracted by various aspects of nature. We can hear shepherd's pipes and distant thunder in Berlioz's Fantastic Symphony, in Schubert's Erlkönig, a wild horseback ride on a stormy night, in Smetana's Moldau, the flow of a river, in Mahler's Ging heute Morgen über Feld, a morning walk in the countryside. And just again, quick jump to